Hi everyone and welcome to this video. In this one, I will cover how to upgrade the firmware or bootROM of a Mac Pro 4.1 to that of the 5.1. The steps to do this have been covered in a lot of videos before, but I noticed that this process is broken for some time now. By reading, experimenting and a bit of reverse engineering, I managed to find a working workaround for this issue, so that's exactly what I will cover here. I also have these instructions documented on my blog in a reading form, for which you can find a link in the description in case you would be interested. As is fairly known, an Apple Mac Pro 4.1, also known as the early 2009 model, is nearly identical to a Mac Pro 5.1, known as the mid-2010 model. For a long time now, it has been possible to flash the firmware or bootROM of the 4.1 to that of the 5.1. There are quite some advantages in flashing your 4.1 with that firmware of a newer 5.1. It enables native support for newer macOS versions up to Mojave instead of El Capitan, adds additional features like booting from NVMe, and probably the most important, it enables support for a whole new range of 6-core CPUs. This opens the door to a whole next level of upgrades, and it is one of the reasons why this machine became and still is so popular. The process to flash or upgrade the firmware has been pretty straightforward. Back in 2011, user MacEFIROM posted a simple tool called MacPro 2009-2010 Firmware Tool on the netcast.org forum, which made it very easy to do this upgrade or go back to the original 4.1 firmware. This tool has been working for a very long time and never let me down until now. Unfortunately, the netcast.org forum has been long gone and the tool seems unmaintained for an even longer time. As that tool requires internet access to download certain data, I assume some of the online resources have moved or there are issues with the TLS connectivity due to outdated certificates or increased security requirements. As a result, at least in my recent attempts, although it looks like everything is working, I do no longer manage to flash a 4.1 system with 5.1 firmware using this method. So what is the problem exactly? Well, the normal process to flash a 4.1 system to a 5.1 is to go through the following steps. First, I would typically perform a clean installation of macOS El Capitan, which is the latest supported macOS version when you're still on 4.1 firmware. After that, I would disable SIP or System Integrity Protection by booting in recovery mode. Next, we need to download the 5.1 firmware from Apple's website and mount it, followed by running that MacPro 2009-2010 firmware tool. The tool we'll then prepare everything for the actual firmware flash, which we then do by shutting down the machine and holding down the power button until the power LED flashes and you hear a long tone. This starts the upgrade process, indicated by an ejecting CD/DVD drive and a progress bar on the screen. After this, the machine should reboot and the firmware should now be flashed to that of a 5.1. What I've noticed with recent attempts to go through this is that during the process, everything looked exactly as if it worked and there were no error messages when running the firmware tool. But when trying to apply the actual update by holding down the power button, the power LED would still be flashing and I do hear a tone. But instead of seeing that progress bar, macOS starts to boot as normal and the firmware does not get updated. To try and overcome this issue, I did an extensive search, lots of reading, and tried a lot of suggested solutions. For example, I used different memory as I suspected a bad or wonky module, I replaced the CR2032 battery on the mainboard as this apparently could be a cause of this, I did a clean install of OS X Mavericks and ran the tool, same with OS X Yosemite, and I did another clean install of OS X El Capitan on an Apple hard drive instead of SSD, as some posts mentioned that this could cause a similar issue. I also tried to rename the DMG file to EFI2010.dmg as some people recommended that, and I tried different patched and unpatched versions of that MacPro 2009-2010 firmware tool. But unfortunately, none of that seemed to help and everything resulted in the same behavior each time when trying to flash the firmware. Eventually, after some more reading and digging through the archived netcast.org forum, I found the following post from a user called VerveGuide, with only a single post on the forum. The theory here is that the MacPro 2009 to 2010 Firmware 2 needs both the old 4.1 firmware and the new 5.1 firmware for the upgrade, not only the new file. Those files are supposed to get downloaded by the tool from Apple's website, except when you, like I always did, download and mount the 5.1 firmware yourself before running the tool. In that case, it would not download the new firmware, but I suspect it still needs the old one, and that is probably where it goes wrong. This gets a bit more confirmed by the following error message when trying to run the tool without internet connectivity, even with a 5.1 firmware supplied as mounted DMG. Clearly, it needs something more from the internet. I also noticed that when trying to run the tool using no self-downloaded firmware, it would always fail with this 5570 error message. This means that when I do not supply the new 5.1 firmware, the tool probably is not able to download it either, which adds to my suspicion that downloading that required old 4.1 firmware most likely also fails. So the question is now, how can we solve this? Well, as we suspect, the issue seems to be that the MacPro 2009 to 2010 firmware tool is no longer able to download the required firmware files from the internet. Unfortunately, in the tool, there is no easy way to change the URLs or download method, and it's only possible to let the tool use a self-downloaded DMG file for the new 5.1 firmware, not for the old 4.1 version. The workaround that I made for this, constructed largely with the help of that post that I mentioned from Verve Guy on the archived netcast.org forum, is to use the following process instead. So first, we need to make sure that we have that system integrity protection disabled if we are on El Capitan, so far nothing different. Then we will run the MacPro 2009 to 2010 firmware tool without any mounted firmware and let it fail with a 5570 error. Even though it fails, it still created the required ROM disk and file structure which we need. Next, we need to manually download the latest 4.1 and 5.1 firmware from Apple's website and slightly change these to have a unique name so we can identify them. Once we have these, we will replace or update the script that is used in the firmware tool app to use these downloaded files and manually execute that, followed by manually running the script in there that prepares everything to do the actual upgrade. And finally, we will do the actual upgrade as if the firmware tool would have run without any issues. Now that we know the steps from a high level and understand the process, let me go through these step by step. So, starting point for this whole process is my MacPro 4.1, as you can see here. Currently, it is on bootROM version MP41.0081.B07. I did test this with a Mac that was on MP41.0081.B08 as well, in case you would be wondering. If you try to go through this process from OS X El Capitan or 10.11.6, which I do recommend and is the latest officially supported macOS version on a 4.1, you will need to disable SIP or System Integrity Protection, as it would prevent you from changing system files. To do so, simply reboot or boot the machine while holding Command plus R on the keyboard. This will boot recovery mode, and once you are there, open the terminal window by navigating to Utilities Terminal on the top bar. In the terminal, if you want, you can check the current status of SIP, and to disable it, type csrutil disable. As instructed, restart the machine. Back in macOS, we can double check if SIP is really disabled now by opening terminal and using the command csrutil status. System integrity protection is clearly disabled, so we're all good here. The next step is to run that MacPro 2009 to 2010 firmware tool to create the RAM disk. I provided the link in the description to download the tool if you can't find it elsewhere anymore. In the tool itself, simply click on upgrade to 2010 firmware and enter your user's password. As explained before, as we are running the firmware tool without any mounted firmware, it will end up with the 5570 error, as you can see. This is fine for what we want. Even though the tool can't completely do its work, a lot of the preparation which we need has been done in that mounted ROM disk which we now have over here. Next up, we need to download the firmware files from Apple's website. I already opened the links from them in Safari, which, as you might notice, is a bit too old to render those pages properly now. As with the firmware tool, I also provided the link for these in the description. Let's first download the firmware called MacProEFI Firmware Update 1.4. This is firmware for the 4.1. and once downloaded, I will immediately rename the file to fw14.dmg. This is to not mix it up with the other file, as both files will get downloaded with the same name. Now let's do the same for the 5.1 firmware called MacProEFI Firmware Update 1.5. This one we will rename to fw15.dmg. We have the required firmware now, but we will need to mount both files simultaneously. To make sure we can use a unique name for each of them, it is better to convert the compressed DMG files to read-write. To do so, we need to open Disk Utility and choose Images Convert from the top menu. Navigate to the downloaded files and start with fw14.dmg. Set the image format to read-write. Choose to save it in the same downloads folder, name it fw14rw and click Save. Repeat the same for the fw15.dmg file. If all went well, your files should look like this. You can use the different file sizes from my screen recording to make sure you have the correct names. Now that we have the firmware files read-write, we can mount them one by one and change the name of the mount point. Simply double-click on the fw14rw.dmg file to mount it. Then right-click on it in Finder and choose Rename. Change the name from MacProEFI Update to MacProEFI Update 2009. Repeat the same for that fw15rw.dmg, but this time name it MacProEFI Update 2010. As you can see, what we got now is the RAM disk and two volumes, one with the firmware for the 4.1 and the other for the 5.1. The next step is to modify or replace a script called ExtractAndPatchEFIFiles.sh in the MacPro 2009 to 2010 Firmware Tool application. I provided the link for the modified version in the description as well, but I have it prepared here on my machine. In Finder, right-click on the MacPro 2009 to 2010 firmware tool.app and choose for Show Package Contents. In Contents Resources, we can see the original script with the same name. The goal of the script is to extract the mounted 2009 and 2010 firmware files to the RAM disk volume and to patch them. As you can see, the updated version on the left we'll use the mount point as we just created from the downloaded firmware files. All we need to do is to replace the original file in the contents of the Firmware Tool application with the modified version and confirm that we want to replace it. We're almost finished now with our preparation. At this stage, we need to run that modified script manually, so it can copy the data from the mounted firmware files to the RAM disk and get it patched. To run the script, open a terminal window and navigate to the folder that contains the MacPro 2009 to 2010 firmware tool.app. In my case, it's on the desktop in a folder called FWUP. Then navigate into the application folder /contents/resources. You can use tab to complete this path. In here, we can find that modified file called ExtractAndPatchEFIFiles.sh. Then we can execute it with a ./ in front of it. This tool should now have created the patched firmware files in these two folders in the mounted RAM disk here, as you can see. The last step in the preparation is to put the patched firmware files, which are until now contained in that RAM disk, in the right location on the system and blast them so they can get used when we're doing the actual firmware upgrade by holding down the power button. In the Firmware Tool app, we can see that there are two scripts for that. One called downgrade EFI 2010 to 2009.sh and another one called upgrade EFI 2009 to 2010.sh. The first one, as the name clearly indicates, would prepare the files to restore the 4.1 firmware after an upgrade already took place. And the second one, the one we need, will prepare the required files to upgrade from a 4.1 to a 5.1. So let's execute that script, as in the previous step, in the same terminal window by running sudo ./upgrade EFI 2009 to 2010.sh and pressing Enter. After entering your password, there is a lot of output, but that's what we want to see. At this stage, your MacPro 4.1 is fully prepared for the firmware upgrade. This would be exactly the same as if you were able to complete the MacPro 2009-2010 firmware tool without any issues. Now, to complete the actual firmware upgrade, we can just follow the instructions you would get in that case. So, let's shut down our machine first. Then press and hold the power button. Eventually, you should see a flashing power LED and hear a long tone, followed by the regular boot chime. After some time, you should get a progress bar, which is a bit thicker than a normal boot progress bar, and a CD/DVD drive will open. After this completes, the DVD drive will close again and the system should boot back into El Capitan. Let's have a look now at About This Mac and use System Report to check if our firmware update was successful. In my case, as you can see, the model identifier became a MacPro 5.1, and the bootROM version is now MP41.0071F.B03. From now on, this Mac supports up to macOS Mojave and can use those much faster 6-core CPUs which I mentioned. Good to see that this workaround, although it's a lot more work, still does the job to upgrade a MacPro 4.1 to a 5.1. Now, as you can see, we ended up with bootROM version MP41.0071F.B03. This is the first and oldest version for a 5.1. Ideally, you would like to upgrade all the way up to the latest available version, which is 144 and 4 zeros. The process to do this is quite long as well, and I did cover this before in another video, for which I will put a card here and a link in the description as well. The good news is that this is exactly the same as if you would have this bootROM version on a real 5.1. In short, it consists of the following steps. First, you would need to start an upgrade to macOS High Sierra from the current OS X El Capitan. When running the installer, you get similar instructions as with the firmware patchup tool, as you can see. After going through this, that should bring your bootROM version to MP51.0086.B00. Then, you still need to complete the rest of the upgrade to macOS High Sierra, which will allow you to start the macOS Mojave installer when you have a metal-supported GPU in your machine. The Mojave installer will once more provide similar instructions to upgrade the firmware, and after completing that step, you will end up with the desired firmware version 144.0000. That's about everything I wanted to cover on the subject. Thanks a lot for watching. As always, if you have liked this one, a thumbs up would be nice. Let me know how the process goes for you or if you have any questions in the comments, and make sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss out more like this. Thanks again and hope to see you back here soon.